Hi everyone, in this tutorial we'll talk about layouts. So before we start layouts, let me brief you about views and view group. So views are any user interface element that you see on your mobile device as a view. So these can be buttons, radio buttons, text box, checkboxes, text fields, etc. So a collection of views is called a view group. And now talking about layouts, layouts are nothing but subclasses of these view group. So these view, these layouts contain various style views. So actually layouts are nothing but how these views are laid out on your onto your activity. So they must follow certain fashion or certain, say, framework or something, or a blueprint that in which these are laid out on your activity. So these are called layouts. So in Android we have certain kind of layout classes already available for us to use. So these are linear layouts. In linear layouts, we can lay out our views in a horizontal or a vertical fashion. Then we have relative layouts, in which we can, you know, place our views relatively to their parent or to their siblings. So in so these are related to each other at parent-child fashion or sibling fashion. Okay, then we have constraint layouts. Constraint layouts are similar to relative layout, but they are much more flexible. In this case, constraints represent a connection between, connection or an alignment to other views. Okay, so these are laid out according to the constraints. Okay, then we have table layouts, in which we can lay out our views in the form of rows and columns. Okay, in frame layout, we can lay out our views onto or stack our views onto one onto the other view. So like in Facebook, you must have seen your profile picture is laid onto the cover picture. So frame layout is that, is the layout that helps us to do that. Okay, so these are how the linear layout, relative layout and table layout actually look. So moving on, layouts can be created both in XML and in Java. In XML, when you want to create a layout, you can do it in two fashion. You can either drag and drop the linear layout or any constraint, any layout, linear layout, relative layout, constraint layout from the design palette, or you can directly code into the XML file. For that, you need to create a tag. Maybe when you're if you're creating any layout, so if you're creating a linear layout, so you need to create a linear layout tag, and into that tag you can you have to add certain properties. Creating layout, you have to keep in mind that two properties are really necessary for that. Number one is the layout width, number two is the layout height. And if you are creating a linear layout, you need to also add the orientation property to it. So in this layout, you can add various buttons, edit text and text fields. Okay. So when you create layouts in your Java code, in your Java, so for that you need to use the the layout classes. These layouts, every type of layout is nothing but a class in Java. So this linear layout, relative layouts, constraint layouts are actually classes in Java. For to use these classes, you need to create an object of these, and then you can use this in your activities or your Android application. So for using this, if you are creating a linear layout, you create an object of it, you set its orientation using the set orientation method, and then you can add views to it using the add view method. Okay, so this is how you create layouts in Java code. And then if you have to add the width and height, you can use the layout params method in your Java, that, and you can lay out your parameters for your layout, that is how match parent and wrap contains. So that's it for today's tutorial. I'll catch you in next tutorial. Thank you so much for watching.